Hey there, my name is Julie Davey, and I'm excited to talk to you today about how I use essential oils in cooking. And I've been using oils for about 7 years now, and I love them. Obviously, you guys probably know that they are very multi-purpose, but I think a lot of people don't really know or haven't explored the fact that we can use these in cooking. So I want to start by sharing three, what I like to call general rules of thumb. So the first one is converting the amount of essential oils that you use in your dishes, especially if you're used to using dried herbs and maybe even fresh herbs. So the amount of dried herbs that a recipe calls for, you typically won't need to use near as much of your essential oil, right? So one drop of essential oil will typically replace about 1 teaspoon of a dried herb or about 1 tablespoon of a fresh herb. Now that's, again, just kind of a general rule of thumb and things to think about. Each oil is a little bit different, and I'll get into specifics as we go on. But things like citrus oils, you may end up using a little bit more than you would think. So if a recipe, let's say, calls for the zest of 1 lemon, you might use anywhere from 4 to 8 drops of lemon. The thing to always remember is to add less, and then you can always taste and add more as you go. You should always be tasting your food, as you're making it anyway. So the second rule of thumb is diluting. Now, I want you to think about this as kind of just like you're diluting and putting your oils on topically. We want to kind of disperse the oil into our dish or our recipe, right? I've definitely made the mistake of not doing this before. I put some ginger in fried rice once and I didn't dilute it into a liquid, and it was definitely concentrated in certain areas, and that's not what we want. We want kind of an even distribution. So using things like other oils, maybe it's an olive oil or a coconut oil, or honey, anything, any type of liquid that you're going to add to a dish, you can put your drops of essential oil right in that, whisk it together, and then add it all to the dish at the same time. And that, again, helps to kind of distribute and disperse the oil throughout the dish. Okay, the third kind of general rule of thumb is delaying. And what I mean by that is delaying when you're adding essential oils to hot dishes. I like to wait until the end or right near the end of the cooking process. So think about things like soups and stews or even maybe spaghetti sauce. Because the oils are relatively fragile, they will kind of dissipate often in a really hot recipe. So you want to, again, add it right at the end so that you get kind of the most bang for your buck, so to speak. You get all of that flavor in there. Now, if you're making a large dish of something, then you can, for the most part, start with 1 drop of essential oil. So think like a big pot of stew, something like that. But if you're making a very small dish of something, then another kind of method that you can use is what I like to call the toothpick method. And this is basically just taking a toothpick, sticking it right down in the decanter on your essential oil, and then swirling it into whatever mixture you have there. So that's just going to kind of flavor it a little bit, and it won't be overpowering. Remember, you can always add more, but you can't take it away, right? So always start with less. If you're questioning it, just always start with less. Now, another question that I get often is, why would you not just use herbs? And to be honest, I still use a lot of herbs in my cooking, but if I have an essential oil that will replace an herb, then that's typically what I'm going to go for. And here are a few reasons why. So when I'm out of an herb, obviously I've got my oils there, right? So maybe I forgot to restock, or honestly, it's just easier to keep these oils around often than herbs because the oils are so multi-purposed. Herbs, the shelf life of a dried herb is typically around 6 months, and then it just really just starts to, maybe even before that, it starts to lose its flavor. And I mean, think about like that bottle of, you know, oregano, dried oregano you have in your pantry that's been there for like 2 years, right? You're obviously going to get, you know, much more flavor out of your essential oil. And again, they're multi-purpose. You can use that one, take oregano oil, for instance, for a multitude of other things. So super convenient, super easy. Now, what about when a recipe calls for a perishable herb? So things like, I love to cook with basil and cilantro, and they're great fresh, but a lot of times you just don't have fresh herbs on hand, and maybe you're going to make something really quick for dinner, and you're like, oh, I don't have any fresh basil that this recipe called for, or fresh cilantro. Well, if you have your essential oil, you don't need that, and that really saves you money, because you know, you already have your oils that you're using for other things, and you don't have to go and buy and purchase those fresh herbs. Now, when you are in need of kind of like a concentrated kind of like pop of flavor, then because our oils are so concentrated, they're really great to add to dishes just for that brightening up of, you know, of a dish, so to speak. So now I want to share with you what some of my favorite oils are and how I use them in my kitchen. So the first one, probably the most common that most of you are familiar with using, is lemon. Now, any recipe that calls for lemon zest, and a lot of people don't really even know how to zest a lemon. So you don't have to know. You just use your essential oil, right? Because that is what lemon essential oil is. It is the zest of the lemon, the oil extracted from the zest of the lemon, because that's where all the concentrated, really delicious lemony flavor is. So anytime a recipe calls for lemon zest, you can use your essential oils. Now, what if a recipe calls for lemon juice and you don't have any lemons, but you really want to make this recipe? So here's a tip for you. You can add, you can take some vinegar, whatever the amount of lemon juice is, take that same amount of vinegar and add a drop of lemon essential oil. Now, it's not going to be exactly the same flavor, but that's probably as close as you're going to get, and it will totally work, especially in a pinch when you don't have lemon juice. That will totally work. The next one that I love to use is lime. Lime juice, you know, a lot of people don't keep limes on hand either, right? But a lot of recipes call for limes. I use lime zest and juice, or actually I use my oil, but in a recipe like a flank steak fajita, it's really great to use the lime essential oil. Salsa would be another great, great one to use it in. Guacamole, use it all the time, my lime essential oil, and cilantro essential oil in guacamole. Tortilla soup is another one. So just think anything that calls for lime zest or lime juice, because most recipes aren't calling for a ton of lime juice. You can probably get away with just the adding the lime essential oil. I also really love it in sparkling water. It's just super refreshing to add a drop of lime to that. Now, the next one is also a citrus oil, and I absolutely love this one because it's so strong and so concentrated, and that is wild orange. And if you've not had wild orange paired in desserts, it's so good. So I love it with chocolate. So something like a chocolate bark or like chocolate truffles, and you put a little bit of wild orange in there. I also make a really good wild orange cranberry bread. So think about baking it with breads and muffins. They're really great. It's really great to use wild orange. And then another one. So you probably have either tasted this before or you've seen it at a party. It's the fruit dip that everybody loves to bring to a party that, you know, is typically loaded with sugar, and it's a kind of a cream cheese mixture. So what I like to do in place, and this is, I promise you, this is like the easiest thing ever, and it is a crowd pleaser. Everybody loves it. Get some vanilla yogurt. So a lot healthier for you, right, than some of those fruit dips. So get some vanilla yogurt and put 2 to 3 drops, based on the amount that you have, if you have kind of a bigger tub of it, put 2 to 3 drops of wild orange in there, stir it up, and use that as your fruit dip. People go crazy over that. It's so good. And you could also just eat that with some granola for a really healthy breakfast. Wild orange is excellent in smoothies as well. Let's see, ginger. Ginger, I really don't keep fresh ginger at all because ginger goes bad in the refrigerator pretty quickly. And you have to put it in the freezer. And then sometimes you're like, what is this? I don't even know what this is that I stuck in my freezer, right? So ginger essential oil I use all the time in my kitchen, especially in like that fried rice recipe that I was referring to earlier. Just make sure that you mix it with, again, a liquid to sort of dilute it and add it to the dish all at once. And it's really good for baking too. Cookies, breads. I love ginger in teas, in smoothies. It's great. And next is thyme. So these are kind of, these others that I want to mention to you are kind of more savory, I would say, herbs that I like to use in cooking. So thyme you can use in place of fresh or dried thyme, of course. So things like soups and stews that call for thyme. I use it in Italian dishes like spaghetti or lasagna. Basil. Basil is amazing in marinara sauce. It's great in pesto. It's great in salad dressing. I love a balsamic salad dressing, just balsamic vinegar, olive oil, a little bit of garlic, and a drop of basil, and it tastes so fresh. So definitely try that out. Oregano is another one. Use it in my spaghetti sauce. We have spaghetti night almost, probably not every week, but maybe every other week. And I put 1 to 2 drops of oregano in my spaghetti sauce. It's delicious. And then peppermint. So peppermint, if you have never made peppermint brownies, you definitely should make peppermint brownies. They're delicious. I typically use about 3 to 4 drops in a brownie mixture in the batter. You do want to put that in the batter and then bake it. And it's just this hint of minty deliciousness. Also in coffee, in hot cocoa, in teas, peppermint's great. And then lastly, kind of a few others that you might want to think about using are things like cardamom and black pepper, lavender also. Sometimes recipes call for lavender. Marjoram, spearmint, cinnamon, and grapefruit. Those are all amazing essential oils to cook with. So I hope that this was helpful to you and that I've given you at least a few ideas of ways that you can make your oils even more useful. Again, they're so multi-purpose. We know how pure and how clean they are. We don't have to worry about any of those things in using them in our cooking and in our baking. So, all right, you guys, have a great day.